Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name's Brittany at Coslit Candle Co. and I make videos about everything you need to run your candle business. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about the equipment you need for making a candle. So let's get started. So if you're new to candle making and you don't know about the candle making kits you can buy at Hobby Lobby and Michaels and on Amazon, you can always start there and get some supplies and try it out for yourself and you'll have everything you need. If that's not something you're interested in though, you can always search around for different equipment and make it your own and kind of personalize it and tailor it to you. So that's what I did. I do want to try a Hobby Lobby kit at some point, maybe review it, but as of right now I use my own supplies. Besides candle wax and fragrance oil, you'll need a pouring pitcher, which I think I've talked about this one before. It's about 4 pounds. It holds 4 pounds of wax. I love it. I only have one right now and I just wash it out in between uses and that's perfectly fine for me. I didn't have a lot of money starting out, so I kind of make do with what I have and I'm trying to grow my business as I go. So using just one is perfectly fine for me. You also need a thermometer and a kitchen scale, a regular old kitchen scale. Some people also have hand scales for their fragrance oil, but I find it perfectly fine to just use it like this. I'm not too picky. I found these at Walmart and I also got my ladle for my Presto pot at Walmart as well. And then I'm also gonna be talking about your heat source. You need a heat source when you're making candles. So I started on a stove and then I moved to my double burner. I already had one, but you can also find one of those at Walmart as well. After doing that, I moved to my Presto pot. My boyfriend had gotten me one for my birthday and I started using that and it was 1,000 times easier. My Presto pot can hold up to 16 pounds of wax, so that's a huge help when I'm making bulk candles. I absolutely love my Presto pot, and if you're gonna be making candles as a job or as a business, I really highly recommend you look into a Presto pot or even a Digi boiler. Those are a little bit more expensive. They also have Presto pots with nozzles. I don't have a little spigot to dump the wax out into the pot, but I make do with what I have with my ladle. So after you have your heat source and everything you need to melt your wax and mix your candle, you'll need to move on to the jars and the tins, and I have mine right here. I did just do a video recently about how I picked mine out, and I'll link that for you below if you want to check it out. It's a quick video, I think it's about 10 minutes long, and it has a lot of secret little tips I put in there for you guys. After that, it is wick stickers and then wicks. I pre-tab mine, but so this is important. On Amazon, you can get wick stickers. Obviously not in bulk like this, but you can get them on Amazon. I don't recommend you doing that though. Every wick sticker I've gotten off of Amazon has been atrocious. It's been nothing but problem after problem. When I was in my testing phase, it gave me so many headaches trying to figure this out. Obviously, alcohol does help adhere those wicks to the jar, but I find that Amazon wick stickers are less than par. And then my wicks, I just showed you that I had pre-tabbed them. 6 inches. I get them from the same site. I get them from Candle Science as well as my wick stickers. I absolutely love Candle Science. They're fast, they're efficient, their customer service is amazing, and you get free samples after spending I think it's $40-$45. You get a free sample with your order, and that is huge as a candle maker because it's gets a little difficult buying all of these samples and you run up a huge bill, but you end up becoming addicted to them and it's just a huge thing. So thank you, Candle Science, for your free samples. After that, you need a wick holder. I use these. A lot of people don't actually, like, there are popsicle sticks with holes in them, or a lot of people will use their stirrers and they'll wrap it around the wicks as they go, or a pen. Some people use cotter pins. Cotter pins look nice, especially when you have a jar like this. It's about 3.5 inches, about 3.25 inches in diameter. When you have a jar like that, you want to get 5-inch cotter pins. It's the easiest way to wick a jar, honestly. I just use these for right now just because, you know, I bought them. I have them. Why waste them? I have like 40 of them, I think it is. So it honestly helps me to just use these. And then you need wick trimmers, which I think are self-explanatory. I got these off Amazon for about, I think it was $8. And they have rose gold ones, gold, white, all different kinds, silver. I think the silver ones are the cheapest. One thing I did want to talk about, though, is the cost of all of this. It cost me about $75 for all of this stuff. And that's including my $35 Presto pot. But if you're not getting a Presto pot and you're not getting a double burner, it'll cost you about $35 to $45 for all of this stuff, which isn't too insane just as you're starting out. Obviously, you can expand as you go. Walmart's a huge lifesaver. Amazon's a huge lifesaver. But you can always start small and build up as you go. Okay, everyone, I think that's it for today. This week has been absolutely crazy. I've been trying to expand and look into making wax brittles and sample packs and fire starters. So I've been crazy busy trying to get everything done, trying to expand and grow, especially right before the holidays because it is candle season. So I want to be ready for that. So I will be doing videos about how to make all of this stuff, fire starters especially. I think I'm most excited about that. So there's a lot in the works. So if you did enjoy this video and you want to see more like it, just like and subscribe, give me a comment for some feedback, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!